folks. Welcome to another Triple T Thursday. For those just joining us, that's tools, tips, and talk. We'll discuss info for the knife maker. So for today's episode, I had a company reach out to me and want to send me one of their digital calipers. And I thought, oh, I already have a digital caliper. But then I thought, there's a lot of uses for a digital caliper that maybe folks don't know or some folks aren't familiar with it. And it is a tool that I use every single day in the shop, multiple times all the time. So I thought it would be good to talk about it, talk about its uses, just in case you don't use it to its full capacity. So let's go down to the table. I'll show you this digital caliper and what it can do and how it can help you in the shop. Let's take a look.
So these calipers are from Q-Fun. There's a link down in the description. They are an Amazon link, so you can get them on Amazon. I think they're $26, so which is a pretty good deal for these kind of calipers. So open it up here. All right, instruction guide. I'll go through everything, so hopefully you won't need that. A little cleaning rag and calipers. I see it also comes with an extra battery, which is good and typical. I like that the measurements here are very clear. Sometimes these are just like black on silver. Here they're red and black, which is really nice. Very typical for calipers that I've seen. There's a thumb screw to kind of go slowly, or you can move them fast like this. And the normal use for calipers is really just to measure things. Like, I want to measure how big this razor is, and I would put it in here and measure it. Okay. There's some interesting aspects to this that I'm going to go over. First off, there's a flat area here. When you're measuring something like this, maybe leave some a little different, like this that had flat areas, you want to make sure you get those flat areas there, because if you're just using the tip, then these are really narrower, so you can get it a little kind of angled, but you won't on the flat areas. So that's just some tips for better measurement. So here you can see I've got it set in inches. Okay, but you can easily switch between fractional, which is really nice if you wanted to, you know, what is the nearest fractional measurement, or for you folks over non-US, I guess, you could do it in millimeters. And one thing about, particularly for my US folks, you're going to, being a knife maker or machinist especially, you will start to think in thousandths of an inch. And typically you're dealing with measurements that are less than an inch, so you're just going to read off these numbers. So 367 thousandths. And you'll get to know those measurements more than the fractional ones, like 3/16 and 1/8. And you're going to know what, you know, 1/8 is 0.125. You're going to know those more than you're going to know the fractional ones. And you'll start to refer to all measurements in thousandths. So if you're not there yet, I suggest you start to learn that and be fluent in those kind of measurements. There's a way to zero this. So if I wanted to, okay, I want to see how much bigger something is, like I measured something else and it was this big, you can now hit zero and see, oh, it's, you know, 339 thousandths bigger. So that is how most people use calipers, and that's kind of where they end. You know, just using calipers to do measurements, outside measurements. There's a couple other things that these are useful for. Inside measurements. If I wanted to measure this hole, these things are good to measure the inside measurement. That's what these things are for. So when you want to measure, you know, I don't have anything else that's got a hole in it, but when you want to measure like this, you want to measure how wide this is. That's what these measurements are for. And the same thing, these, you'll notice these are very kind of sharp. That's because you want to get, you want the widest part here, and you want to make sure you can, move that around until you get the widest part. So that for outside measurements, inside measurements, obviously there's a lock when you have the measurement that you're taking here and you want to maybe scribe it on something, measure it on something. It's always good to lock it. A lot of people will use these for scribing. The $26 ones or whatever, these are just going to be stainless steel. Okay. These will wear pretty easily if you use them for marking. So unless you spend, $100 or whatever, and you get ones that actually have carbide tips or something on them, you will wear them out by measuring them. I mean, it won't hurt them. It won't affect the way they measure. You're just not going to get clearer marks as time goes on, because you're going to wear these out. Other things that this has, of course, it has an actual scale measurement here. So if you wanted to just do a rough measurement of something, you can. I don't know why you would. I never really use the scale very much, but it is somewhat useful. So the last thing that a lot of people don't even know about calipers is a depth measurement. And that's the back end of the tool can be used. So I'm going to zero it. Now, if I want to measure the depth of this hole, I can put this little thing down here until it hits the bottom. And then I will know it is 344 thousandths deep, or essentially that's the thickness of this. But if this hole bottomed out, I would be able to do a depth here. So a lot of people don't think to use that way to measure with these. There's also a conversion scale on the back if you want to do metric to imperial. There's a bunch of easy conversions on the back. So really useful tool. You're going to use them all the time. It's good to have a couple in the shop in different areas. They're really invaluable. And now I like the fact that I have a second one I can leave by the mill and by the lathe, that I don't have to keep moving it back and forth. All right, guys, I hope you got something out of today's episode. If you don't have a set of calipers, or everybody needs a couple, go down into the description. You'll find a link to this. And it also is an Amazon affiliates link, so I get a little kickback from that as well. So go take a look, pick one up, and we'll see you on the next one. Thanks, guys.